Alright guys, so as you can see, 2102 is sitting here at the very new Nesquehoning Regional Railroad Station here at the new Nesquehoning campus of the Reading and Northern Railroad. It'll be departing here at 9 a.m. sharp, and it'll head north all the way through the Lehigh Gorge, through Pittston, and all the way up to Tunkhannock for the very first time. In fact, this is the first time an Iron Horse Ramble has gone anywhere besides Reading to Jim Thorpe in return. But anyways guys, we're chasing today. Got a ton of good shots planned. We're gonna go from here to Whitehaven first for a shot I've never done before, but I think it's gonna be really good. And then I think if I'm remembering correctly, we're gonna catch 2102 meeting the PIJT at Crestwood. And well, you're just gonna have to wait to see what happens after that. Who's also chasing would be Chase. And probably several other hundreds of our friends, probably, I guess.
Hundreds?
Yeah. Well, I don't know. There's going to be
thousands, but all right.
Maybe thousands.
Let me put it light.
there's going to be a lot of people, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah.
But anyways, guys, stay tuned and enjoy.
Thank you.
Once the train arrived in Penobscot, two of the railroad's fast freight SD50-2s were added to the head end of the train in front of 2102 as the tender was being refilled with water. The diesels were added to utilize their dynamic brakes coming down the steep Penobscot mountain grade into Pittston, Pennsylvania, as using just the air brakes on the train would have caused significant strain on the brake shoes. Once the train arrived in Pittston Yard, the diesels were taken off and 2102 led the train north to Tunkhannock. While everyone enjoys 2102 leading, the diesels being added for this small portion of the trip actually aligns nicely with how the original Iron Horse Rambles from the Reading Railroad days operated, as portions of those excursions were also diesel-powered or assisted.
that one. girls, was that worth coming down for?
Alrighty, so as you guys saw, 2102 just arrived in Tunkhannock, Pennsylvania. All the passengers have unloaded. The train has shoved down the main line to reload the tender with water and also service the locomotive. So I'm going to take this time to head into town, find a food vendor, get some lunch, and prepare for the departure later. So stay tuned for that. I'll be back later.
Thank you.
Alrighty guys, so the layover here in Tunkhannock is just about over. 2102 is reattached to the back of the train. And as you can see, it is currently arranged tender first. And that's how it's going to lead going from Tunkhannock down to Pittston. And once they get to Pittston, they're going to run just 2102 around the Y. And then it'll lead all the way up the grade back to Penobscot. And then continue all the way to Nesquehoning. Now I was going to catch a departure here in Tunkhannock. But after navigating up here for the first time, there is quite a bit of traffic today with the festival in town. So I think I am going to head down the line a bit, probably to Falls, which is a location that I did not get on the northbound trip. I did not make it in time. So I think I'm going to head out now. I'm going to catch it there, and then we'll continue on down the tracks. Well guys, as you can see, the train is back here in the station. It's been a very long but exciting day here on the Reading and Northern Railroad. I've had a great time chasing the second Iron Horse Ramble all the way from Nesquehoning up to Tunkhannock and return. I just want to say thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next adventure. Bye bye.